Now in this video, we'll look at the concept of psychrometric chart. So this is how a psychrometric chart would look like. It has lots of lines, vertical, horizontal, slant. Okay. Now there are two main axes. The horizontal axis shows the dry bulb temperature and the vertical axis shows the specific humidity. Right. So these vertical lines in black, they show the dry bulb temperature. So TdB1, this is TdB2. So this is how it will be shown. So let us say if you have a dB of 25 degrees Celsius, so 25 over here, this entire line is showing 25 degrees Celsius of DVT. Okay, then you have the horizontal lines which cut on the vertical axis. So this is the specific humidity. Let us say this is omega 1 kg of water vapor per kg of dry air. Okay, so this is what this axis is showing. So this entire horizontal line indicates omega 1 value of specific humidity. Now you have these slant lines. Okay. Now these black colored slant lines, there are two kind of slant lines. One is the black colored one and the other one is this red colored slant line. Okay. So the black colored slant line, they indicate the wet bulb temperature. So this is wet bulb temperature. Okay. And when this wet bulb temperature meets this line, this is the saturation line. Okay. So when this wet bulb temperature line meets this point, means this line, this point gives us the dew point temperature. Okay. Now you extend this WBT line and you cut this line. Okay. So this point shows the enthalpy value at that particular condition. Okay. So this is what the psychrometric chart will tell you. It will tell you the dry bulb temperature, the specific humidity, the wet bulb temperature line, the dew point and the enthalpy. Okay. And there are two lines left. These red colored lines and these blue colored curves. Okay. These blue colored curves are the relative humidity line, that is RH line. So this is, let us say, this black. So this is phi 1, this is phi 2, this is phi 3 and this is phi 4. So as you go from this side onto the saturation line side, your RH keeps on increasing and this saturation line has a phi of 100%. Okay, so let us say if this is 100% RH, this would be somewhere about 80% RH, this would be 70% RH and so on and so forth. So it will keep on decreasing towards that side. Now we come to these red colored lines. These red colored lines are showing specific volume. So this line, this shows a volume, let us say 0.05 meter cube per kg. So this entire line, this shows the specific volume of the vapors at that particular temperature and pressure condition. So in a nutshell, your psychrometric chart would give you information about DBT on the horizontal axis. It will give you the information about omega on the vertical axis. Okay, it will give you information about enthalpy on this axis. It will give you information about WBT. Okay, it will give you information about the dew point temperature. Okay, then you can find out the RH. Okay, and you can also find out the specific volume. So in a nutshell, all these psychrometric terms can be found out through the psychrometric chart. You don't need to remember the psychrometric relations that we did. If you understand how to work around your way with this psychrometric chart, you can solve any question on psychrometry. So now that is what we are going to do in the next video onwards. we look at some basic psychrometric processes that would be used in the numericals. So very, the very first process that we will use and that makes use of this psychrometric chart, that is sensible heating and sensible cooling.